Hi, it's Jeff Chubb with REM Network and here with Jason Bonarigo of RMS Mortgage. And today we're going to talk about the buyer timeline. We constantly get the question, how long does it take in order to close? And this is what goes on in the closing. So first off, Jason, so how fast can we close a loan? If you're getting a mortgage, how fast can we close a loan?
I mean, usually we like to say about 30 days.
Kind 30 of, days, as fast as possible.
That's pretty much the minimum. We like to have 45 to 60, but 30 days is
And on average, quick. It's about 45 days?
I would say that, yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So 45 days from offer accepted to actual closing.
Yep.
So the first step there, right? So we submit the offer. I get it accepted with my client. Great. I send it along to you. What happens then?
You call me with the good news. Obviously, as soon as I get the offer, I start to maybe review the property and the address, the final numbers, what's the purchase price, all those things, pulling the taxes and the information.
Right.
And then, of course, I'm going to reach out to the buyer and say, okay, we're really starting to rock and roll now.
Right.
And obviously cover in more details about the loan application.
And at that time, that's when essentially the first 7 days is when, you know, generally speaking, we have our home inspection contingency.
Sure.
So that's when we're doing, you know, the buyer and I, we're doing our home inspection in order to make sure the house checks out how it's supposed to be.
Yep.
So you're doing that. We're doing this. Everything's great in the home inspection. Maybe, you know, we go back and negotiate our thing or two, which we obviously
But that's
let
a great
you know
point,
now,
Jeff, because
right?
a lot of times we're working on those final figures and maybe I'll hold off on the appraisal a little bit until I kind of get that thumbs up from you or the buyer. Because
well,
as you know, the last negotiations really take place at that home inspection, right?
Right.
Once that's a go, then we really know we're kind of buying this house and we're off and running.
So
that's a good point.
So the purchase and sale agreement. I always call this the engagement ring of the transaction.
The big handshake, as
yeah.
well. Yeah.
So that's when the majority of the deposit goes down. Generally speaking, the offer deposit is a $1,000 deposit,
yeah,
right? And,
yeah.
and sellers generally like seeing 5% of the total purchase
price. And
that's
a big
down,
commitment
right?
for the buyers, right?
Yeah. Exactly. And that's all negotiable and things that we talk with the buyers about. So,
sure.
so we sign the purchase and sale agreement. That happens about 2 weeks after the initial offer is signed,
roughly.
If you have a home inspection,
yeah.
Right? So, okay, we've got the purchase and sale agreement signed. I've just sent it to you. Now what happens?
Then we're really cooking. I mean, then the appraisal's been ordered. If it hasn't been ordered already, we're sending that contract over to the appraiser because they want to review that for any stipulations, and obviously they want to balance that market value,
right.
The estimated value.
How long does it take for the appraisal from they go into the house today? How long does it take for them to actually get that break?
Great question. This is more of a blanket. I'm going to say probably about 7 days.
Right.
Obviously, if we're busy like we are really right now, then obviously sometimes it can take a little bit longer. But
and we can do rush appraisals, right?
We can do rush appraisals. It's tight, but when you're really busy, it gets tough again. But again, about 5 to 7 days on a good appraisal turnaround.
Right. Okay, so purchase and sale agreement signed about 2 weeks after. We've
yep.
ordered the appraisal. You're continuing to do all your financing stuff?
Everything's chugging along.
So they're continuing to send you more docs. Have you sent it to underwriting at this point?
As soon as we get the appraisal back or right in conjunction with right around the time that we kind of put it in the underwriting queue so that as soon as the appraisal comes in, it hits and clears. Because again, as you know, and we don't want to talk about this for a long time, but you don't want a nice issued approval and then it's subject to the appraisal.
Right.
Because that's just a massive condition and you want to take that for the buyers and for the sellers and everyone involved because that's one of the things that could obviously shift the deal, right?
Right.
So we want to get that in about that time, but that's right in between the mortgage commitment, obviously, and the purchase and sale signing.
And so from my average timeline of 45 days, generally when I'm writing up an offer for a buyer, right, the purchase and sale agreement's 2 weeks after,
yep.
and then I have the mortgage commitment 3 weeks after the purchase and sale agreement.
Yeah.
So at this point, we're essentially 5 weeks into the process. We have about a week or so until we're actually closing the loan.
Mm-hmm.
Does that sound right?
Yeah, yeah. And that mortgage commitment, obviously, which we're going to touch on, is one of the last major pieces. Is such
well,
a
that's like the major piece.
That is the major piece. And, we spend a lot of time explaining that, as do you and your team do a fantastic job on that. But just kind of so the buyer understands that when they put in that 5% down or whatever that large amount for them is that they're protected by that mortgage commitment.
If they have a mortgage contingency.
If they have a mortgage right. commitment, which is a whole other topic.
Right. So, all right. So we've got the mortgage commitment. You've issued it. There's still some conditions in that
few final
commitment,
conditions,
right?
Yeah.
Like you need to verify employment, things yep, like
maybe
that.
Maybe a lack pay stub or something like that, but nothing major. They're committed. They're getting the loan.
Right. right. Okay. So that's happening about on average 45 day timeline, about a week before closing.
I would say about 30 days in.
Yep.
Give
about
or take.
40 days
yep,
in.
Yep.
Okay. So and then final figures and closing docs, because all that actually comes from you guys, correct?
That comes from us. And obviously, once we get the famous CTC or the clear to close, as we like to say, and that's when the docs will be.
And when does that happen?
Honestly, really depends on the deal, but I'm going to say about anywhere from 5 to 7 days prior to the closing
okay.
day. Ideally, we'd love to see it before. It just really doesn't happen
now,
that way.
We need that ahead of time because doesn't the government regulate
something? Yep. We have a law called TRID, and they have to have their final figures 3 days prior to the closing by law. We cannot override that. So they have to be disclosed their to-the-penny final numbers 3 days before that they can legally close.
Right. Okay. And then we have closing.
And we have the closing. That's the happy day.
That's the day.
Stressful but happy.
That is.
And they get the keys, and
that's important to remember. You actually get keys and ownership of the house the day that you close, as long as it's recorded.
As long as it's recorded, yeah. And we have to close a little bit earlier in the day to make sure the attorney goes on record.
Right. Again. So, great. Well, I'm Jeff Chubb with the Chubb Homes team and EXP, and we're brokered by EXP Realty. And this is Jason Bonarigo of RMS Mortgage. Jason, how do they contact you?
Just call my cell phone 617-413-5038 or send a text.
And you can always get us at 617-480-2600 or visiting us online at www.boston2.com. Thanks for watching. We look forward to hearing questions from you about the home buying process. We're always looking for ideas. In the meantime, enjoy your day.